Hello my dear students, now welcome back once again online classes. I hope you will be all right and you will be studying at your home. So let's start the second part of the chapter, lesson 3, Taro's reward. So second part which has been left in the last video, so paragraph number 8, let's start. That afternoon our neighbor stopped by for a visit. Taro's father politely offered her a cup of sake. The lady drank it greedily and thanked the old man. Means next day, a neighbor stopped at his home. So his father, means Taro's father, offered her, you can take this sake. When she took, and she was so greedy. It was so greedy, so she was greedy and greedily and thanked to old man. Okay. Then Taro told her the story of the magic waterfall, thanking them for the delicious drink. She left her in hurry. Means thereafter Taro was a very soft-hearted person and very simple person. So Taro told her all the story, how has he got the waterfall and a sweet sake. So the lady was so hurry and say thanked and she went away from their side. By nightfall she had spread the story throughout the whole village. By night, till night, the story spread all night, all over the village. That evening there was a long procession of visitors to the woodcutter's house. Means possession means the lots of people. They came to Taro's house. Okay, each man heard the story of the waterfall and took a sip of the sake. In less than an hour, the pitcher was empty. Means after listening these things, there was a lot of people. We are in front of Taro's house. Everyone demanded a little bit of sake. I need, and Taro's father had given to all. You can taste it, you can take this little bit sake. After drinking, all the people, when all people drank the sake, it has been finished. There was nothing in the pitcher. Pitcher was empty. Okay, so next morning Taro started for work even earlier than the morning before. So similarly, the Taro's work was same. When the Taro has started doing work, he has started a work similarly yesterday. He carried with him the largest pitcher. Now at the time he has a largest pitcher he had at the time, for the intended first of all to go to the waterfall. When he reached it, he found to his great surprise all his neighbors there. He thought, I had a large pitcher and after doing my work I will go to the waterfall, I will fill this large pitcher, then I will go to home and I will offer this drink to my parents. But suddenly what happened, when he reached the waterfall, so he saw there was a lot of people there, and his neighbor also were there. They all were using the water. When he reached it, he found to his great surprise all his neighbors there. They were carrying pitchers, jars, buckets. Means everyone has a pitcher, jar, buckets, anything they could find to hold the magic drink or sake. Then one villager knelt and held his mouth under the waterfall to drink. Thereafter what happened, a villager knelt, means to bow down on their knee. Okay, so he knelt and he started taking water. He drank again, means it was not good taste. So he drank again and again, shouted angrily, so angry, be angry and shouted, water, nothing but water. That's only water, nothing sake. Others also tried, means there was a lot of people, so everyone tried to take sake and that waterfall and that water. Then they told, but there was no sake, only cold water. There was no sake, this is only cold water. We have been tricked, shouted the villagers. Where is Taro? Means this is a trick which has been held by the taro. Let us drown him in this waterfall. Means they told, let's draw him. Draw him means say like a sink, like let's sink taros into the waterfall, let it him die. Okay, but taro had been wise enough to slip behind a rock when he saw how things were going, and he was nowhere to be found. Means when taro listened this thing, taro thought, let should be slipped away here from here, otherwise they will beat me. Muttering their anger and disappointment, they everyone were sad, disappointed. The villagers left the place one by one. Everyone has gone from there. Was it true? And he wondered, was the sheikh a dream? Sheikh was a dream, or sheikh was a real? Okay, but according to us, it was a totally a cold water, not a sheikh. Once more, he caught a little liquid in his hand and put it to his lips. Means taro does not believe the it's himself. Yesterday I have taken this drink, it tastes was sweet, but today villagers when tasted it, so they told that's cold water, not a sake. So is it cold water or sake? Let's check it. So taro checked, taro tasted it. Once more, he caught a little liquid in his hand, and put it to his lips. It was the same fine sake. But when the taro tasted it, it was a fine sake. To the thoughtful son, the magic waterfall gave the delicious sake. That was a magic waterfall who gives a water sake, who gives the sake to those person who is a very kind-hearted man. To everyone else it gave only cold water, and other persons he give, means the waterfall become a cold water to the those person who all were not a kind hearted person. The story of taro and his magic waterfall reached the emperor of Japan. Okay, the story reached where? Japan. He sent for the young woodcutter. Sent for means he called. Sent for means he called to the young woodcutter taro and rewarded him with 20 pieces of gold for having been so good and kind. Being a good and kind person, taro has been rewarded by the 20 pieces of gold. Then he named the most beautiful fountain in the city after the taro. This, said the emperor, was to encourage all children to honor and obey their parents. So Emperor encouraged those people in his their villagers and his near who lives, okay, means in his kingdom, okay, means Japan's king has given and given instructions and given a message and encouraged to their people that you will have to kind-hearted person, you will have to obey your parents, then you will become and you should be honorable person, you should be honored. If you will be like this, so you will be kind-hearted and definitely you will success in your life, and God may bless you forever. So my dear students, I hope you enjoyed this story. It was a beautiful story. Okay, we will meet in the next video for the new story. Till then, thank you.